Mr. Happy Living here, and I'm happy to be broadcasting from WITV7 in the beautiful Queen City, Charlotte, North Carolina, USA. Hey friends, take a moment with me and just imagine how you'd feel living the life you were put on this planet to live, doing work you love, with people you love, in places you love, and all the while creating something of real value to others. That's what I call a life of significance. And I can tell you it's a very happy life. And so can my friend, Roger Fritz. He's my guest star for today. And he's the only person I've ever met who was born to build guitars. Hey, Roger, welcome to the Something Significant Show.
Thank you, Matt. Good to see you.
Awesome. Hey, just take a minute, if you will, and tell our audience what you're doing these days to make your mark of significance on the world.
Well, I'm continuing to do what I've been doing since I was 13 years old. And I build guitars and I build different instruments. And I also do guitar repair and instrument repair. And I've been doing it on a professional level since I was probably about, 18.
Wow.
So that's, my wife calls me a guitar savant.
And explain the word luthier.
Luthier is sort of a newer term that applies to somebody who builds guitars. When I first started doing this, I never heard of that word. And so that's something that has come about in the past 20 years. As you probably might expect, I 20 years ago, I'd been building guitars for maybe 30 years. So I always just called myself a guitar maker or a guitar repairman or a musician too. So really, that's really what kind of got me started. I loved music so much as a child, and guitars was what, I was drawn to. And it was just one of those things I was just, possessed, really. It was, I don't have any other word to describe it. It was just something I had to do. And no matter what, I had to do it.
It's fantastic. I love what you do. And I love that I got to see your shop and see you in action. It's just amazing. So Roger, let's do a little math now and let our friends all across the World Wide Web get to know you through the equation of our happy formula. So it's a simple formula, but it's very powerful. Capacity plus purpose equals happy. So let's start with capacity. What are your personal practices for building your capacity, whether it's physical, mental, spiritual, financial, emotional? What do you do, Roger, on a regular basis to create all the capacity you need to take really good care of yourself and your loved ones and still have plenty left over to give to others?
Well, I would call my capacity, I'm a production manager of my own life. And I've always looked at it that way. And I have a whole lot of parts and pieces that I have to keep up with. And so it's all about my family and, my children, my wife and my siblings and all that kind of stuff. But it's always been that way. And of course, financials is important. So to make the ends meet, I have to be sort of production oriented, which means I have to take inventory all the time, not only of my emotions or spiritual but also of my guitar strings, my wood, mm-hmm. all those kind of things, my glue. And yeah. So all those things all, mean a whole lot to me because I have to, perform at a high level. And so I guess that would be my capacity in a way, because I do have to meet production, mm-hmm. People are expecting me to either build their guitar and deliver it to them, or I have to get these repairs done on time. People are waiting for their guitars to be repaired so I can get it to their gig on the weekend or whatever it might be. And so I'm motivated in that respect that it's a kind of a timely thing. I wake up in the morning and I know what my job is every day, and I, every now and then I'll take a day off and have a party or something, have a little New Year's party or something like that,
Yes, sir.
So, and it's all music is really my main focus because it's all about the love of music and what music does for me personally. And for most people that I know love music. And so we're all sharing music and it's a happy thing.
No, I notice that a lot with musicians. And in your case, it's even more so because you're creating the instrument of the music there as well. And so the whole thing, your whole life is wrapped up and intermingled with family and music and business, and it's all there on the property and people come in. And so it's kind of hard to separate the you from,
yeah,
the guitar, right?
Well, that's right. I mean, you know, I've worked for other companies over my life, but this is my dream, is to have everything, you know, all on my, in my one property here. I have my shop behind my house, and then, you know, it's like my kids live pretty close, and of course my wife is all part of this whole dream. And so we're, you know, basically living out our dream. And this is awesome. I appreciate my life, and, you know, and meeting people like you, and who are, you know, happy. I like happy people, and it's all about fun and being happy. And really, that's why we're doing this, right?
That's why we're doing it. Awesome. Well, before we move on to purpose, let's discuss my favorite capacity building concept called a Kaizen state of mind. It's based on a Japanese idea that small incremental improvements add up over time to yield great big results. A Kaizen state of mind is knowing there's always something I can do better tomorrow than I did today. It's a positive mindset, it's very optimistic, and it creates this gentle yet powerful continuous uplifting of my life day after day after day. So Roger, how does having a Kaizen state of mind help you increase your capacity to continuously become more so you can continuously give more?
Okay, well, I've been living that, without knowing it, I've been living Kaizen for many years.
Yeah.
And, you know, trying to, and learning, you know, it's all about learning. And in my case, I mean, you can imagine that over all these years of trial and error, each time I have an error, then it makes me learn something new. And so I've been learning something new since I was, you know, just a kid. Always, yeah, learning something new and being excited about it, because I got something else to make everything better. And so that's really, it applies to my life big time. And I'm learning something new every day. And I when I have problems like that, I'm dreaming in Kaizen.
Yeah.
Early in the morning. Early in the morning, but right before, yeah, I wake up, usually I have a problem trying to figure out what to do. And yeah, I'll be thinking about it, all of a sudden I'll have a dream. And pop, it comes into my head, and I wake up and I go out to my shop, and, you know, it works.
That's the creative process. It's beautiful. And when I was writing this question down for you today, I thought in terms of the process that you've created and perfected over all these years to design and build a guitar. How many small incremental improvements have you brought into that? You know, that here you are as a, you know, 50 years later, this fine-tuned master of build of guitar making. But
well, you can imagine. That's an incredible question, and I wish I could put it into a numbers thing, but it's vast. It's thousands, yeah, thousands and thousands. You know, because of all the different, you can imagine all the different things that go into making, you know, a top of the line instrument. You know. And it's just so many different details. I mean, all the way back to Mother Nature and what God has provided in, you know, natural materials, you know, looking at the natural materials and looking for the finest pieces of wood, things, yeah, like that, you know, that you can possibly find. And even that that's a whole study in itself.
Yeah.
Just looking at wood,
You can give the audience maybe just what you would consider one of the, that normal people like me could relate to, one of the discoveries or even patents or unique things that you've done that's different than other guitar makers, let's say.
Okay. Well, I mean, like I said, I've had all these ambitious ideas of how to improve something that's already, I consider a great thing, you know, like guitars to me are like my ultimate joy and music itself. And so I'm looking for better ways to, you know, to do things other than what people are doing out there. So for one thing, I have a patent, and I had an idea one time that people break strings on their guitars for some reason. And so I came up with an idea for a stainless steel nut, which goes on a stringed instrument which holds the strings in place, which was a certain type of alloy stainless steel where it was self-hardening over time. And so it kept people from breaking strings, and it also became very slick. And so the strings didn't bind up, and so you could tune the guitar better. It sounded better, and it lasted forever. And so I went in that direction and started creating a whole line of things made out of stainless steel, which were the, you know, like hardware for the guitars. And so I just took it from there, and that was a different thing. That was different. And so, and then to have people use them and really, you know, use them to, you know, where you, I listen to somebody play, like, say, you know, George Harrison or Gary Moore or somebody like that, who I consider really incredible guitarists, and hear them play my instruments and hear what they can do with them, you know. Oh, yeah, it just blows my mind, you know. So it's like,
awesome. That's awesome. All right, let's dive into that second element of the happy formula. And Roger, I've observed that oftentimes big life transformations and discovery of purpose comes from devastation, addictions, disease, death, disaster, something, some big crisis strips a life to its core and transformation comes out. However, in my book, second book, Turning Inspiration into Action, I share a transformational process I've used to discover my purpose using inspiration. Mm-hmm. So how about you, Roger? Was there a specific moment or event or crisis or inspiration that revealed to you the purpose you were meant to live?
Well, you know, I'm going to have to say no, because I was born this way. And so I've had a lot of, you know, ups and downs, of course, but you know, I've never had something that was just truly transformational for me, because I transformed myself back when I was just a child, basically. Yeah. And I've been doing this my whole life. And I went to school, I got a college degree, but it had nothing to do with what I'm doing. Yeah. And I did it because, you know, I wanted to make my parents happy, you know, I tried to do that. So I did that. And then as soon as I got out of college, I joined a band. I started, you know, doing what I'm doing. So it's one of those things.
When I was doing my research on you, I came up with the only one I've known born to do this. And then when I got to this question, I have my parentheses. I wish I could show you. It says, I've got nothing. I didn't think you were going to find it. I thought you were just, and I think.
I tried maybe, to figure that out.
Maybe it goes, you can tell the story about when you first made your first guitar, you're 13 years old, and you were trying to get one as a gift. Maybe you can share that story.
My father was an FBI agent, of all things, very conservative. And I'm 70 years old. And so I was brought up there on, you know, the heyday of rock and roll. And so he was very, he didn't like rock and roll. What can I say? And so he didn't want me to have an electric guitar. He didn't want anything to do with that. And so I built a guitar when I was 13 years old. I went down in the basement and borrowed some of my dad's hand tools, and I started building my guitar. And so my second guitar that I built, during that time period, we lived in St. Louis, and my father got transferred to the South. It was during the civil rights movement, and they sent a lot of FBI agents down into Alabama. And so I was so upset about having to move. I guess you could say that was a transformational time. Yeah. I had to move from St. Louis, and I was, you know, 15 years old, and I had built this guitar, and I'm playing in my first, you know, kind of a real band. And so I got so upset, I gave my guitar to my best friend who was in the band with me. And I said, I don't want to play the guitar. I don't want, you know, I hate the guitar. I have to move. And so I gave him my guitar. And as soon as I got down to the South, I said, I shouldn't have done that.
Yeah.
And I called him up and I said, hey, man, I didn't mean to give you my guitar. Can I have it back? And he said, I sold it. And so that's kind of a, you know, I guess that was a transformational, you know, in a way. It inspired me, you know, so I kept on going.
Yeah, very good. All right, Roger. Well, let's take a commercial break, because I want to tell everyone about three things. Okay. A super cool company called Dry Farm Wines, how they deliver chemical-free, sugar-free, health-certified wines right to your doorstep, and how every purchase made for the entire month will support a great big donation to our wonderful host, WITV7.
Excellent.
Mr. Happy Living here. I love good things made by good people. That's why I love Dry Farm Wines. I first met the man known as the healthiest wino on the planet back in 2016. He said his wines don't cause headaches or hangovers, and that he started his company because most wine consumed in the U.S. is highly processed and loaded with unnatural nasties. Like most processed food, it's toxic. That very night, I made a big health decision. Toxic wines out, natural wines in. It's been 4 years since I made the switch, and I feel great. Go to happyliving.com and select Partners in Happy to get your first bottle of natural wine for a penny. And I'll donate 8% of every order placed during the entire month of November to WITV7. Share the gift of natural wine and pour some love this holiday season. And we're back. And this is the Something Significant Show. And I'm Matt Gersper. And my special guest star today is Roger Fritz. Hey, Roger, I love this article called The Science Behind the Power of Giving. I found it on lifescience.com. And it says the act itself, the act of giving itself, can be a gateway to discovering your reason for being on this planet for those of us who weren't lucky enough to be born into it. And this science says, There's compelling data that supports the notion that giving one's time and talents and treasures is a powerful pathway for discovering purpose, transcending difficulties, and finding fulfillment and meaning in life. So, Roger, I updated the formula. Capacity plus purpose plus giving equals really happy. So what do you think, Roger? From your life experience, have you found that giving your time and talents and treasures has been a powerful pathway for discovering your purpose or transcending difficulties you've faced or for bringing real meaning into your life?
I believe in your math. I think it. You got it. And I believe in, I try to give as much as I can. I think I do, you know. We've always tried to give back. My wife, we're both, you know, we're like two peas in a pod. Mm. She gives more than me, of course, but you've met her. And yep. She's like the ultimate giver. I mean, we yep. used to, all we ever did was play benefits, you know, for all these different reasons. And so my wife, Chrissy, would say, okay, we have to give our benefit price, you know, which is, what is it? Nothing? We don't get money, but we get, you know, we get the joy, you know, of helping. Yep. And, you know, I believe in that totally. And it makes sense to me, and I maybe that's one of the reasons that I'm in doing what I do, and why I've had such a, you know, a happy life, really, mostly. I you know, there's always the little ups and downs, of course, with your family over the years and past people passing away and things like that, but you know, life is great.
Yeah, I was talking with a friend of mine today earlier, and about, of course, there's ups and downs, but there's always a bright side and there's always a dark side. And when you're in your darkest moment, you can still look at the bright side of it. And when you're in your best moment, you could choose to look at the dark side of it. So I think it's not about always living sunshine and rainbows and unicorns, but right. You can have that mindset that's towards happiness.
Well, you have to have the dark side in order to expand your creativity in a way, because look at all the things that happen when I'm depressed because I can't solve a problem. And so that depression leads you to come up with a solution, and which in turn makes you, you know, overcome with joy or whatever, you know? Yeah. And so anyway, you know, just, and then, you know, just all your good friends and stuff that, you know, they might get depressed, but then they get together and they write a great song, you know?
Yeah.
Yep. A sad
yeah, so goodness comes out of the troubles and the difficulties, and
right.
And so, and giving, so giving is this scientifically proven benefit, and I agree 100% with it. And I love that wonderful feeling that comes. It's the fourth element of significance, the way I define it, doing work that creates value for others. And I've learned, as you have, that the magic of life comes not from getting more, but from giving more. But Roger, there's something more to it than that. It's not just the giving that's magical. What I've been exploring and learning is it's when you're giving from living in your purpose. Mm-hmm. That's where you find the real magic. So tell us, how does it make you feel when you're giving to others through the work you were put on this planet to do? And an artist who bought a Fritz Brothers guitar tells you it makes them sound better than they really are. or when you hear your own music being played on the radio or TV or on records, or when you see and hear your guitars being played by famous artists on TV and radio, or speaking of famous artists, when you receive a letter from the legendary George Harrison of the Beatles praising a guitar that you made just for him, how does all that make you feel?
Well, I mean, it's hard to put it into words, of course, but you know, if you want to, you know, it makes you break down, you know. It's like when I got that letter from George Harrison, you know, I cried. I mean,
yeah.
I still, when I think about it now, it, yeah, you know, it almost makes me cry. You know, for a guy like him who was you know, such a spiritual guy and such a caring guy. I mean, you would never know, you know, until you had something, an experience like that with somebody like that sending you a letter and praising you. And I'm, you know, I'm just me. And he was like, who knows? He was at the top of the music, you know, food chain.
Yeah.
And so that was, yeah, a great experience, you know. And then, you know, just like you said, when you're, you know, creating either music as a musician, you know, that's one of the most gratifying things is, you know, when you complete something and you think it's good, then somebody else says it's good too. And so it kind of makes us double good, you know. So,
and that's
all those things are awesome, you know.
Yep. And that's, it's easy to understand the music, but it's I believe it's anywhere you're living from your purpose. So if you're a car mechanic and somebody has a problem with their car and you say, oh, it's no problem. And you know, you get under the hood and all of a sudden the problem's solved. And it's like, oh, this is something I can give to you.
Yeah.
And it's giving a part of my soul to you, right?
The feeling of amazing people, you know, yeah, when they're amazed at what you just did, I mean, yeah, it kind of blows you away. You know? Yeah. I mean, really.
And that's it. That's the magic. It's combining purpose and giving to make this great big happy circle. Giving your time and talents and treasures is a powerful pathway to discovering purpose, and discovering purpose and giving from living in your purpose brings about profound joy. So giving leads to purpose and giving from purpose leads to joy. So I've got to tweak my formula a little bit more, Roger,
okay,
to make it reflect the exponential power of giving. Capacity times purpose times giving equals happy to the third power. And that's really, truly, deeply happy. Does that sound about right to you?
It makes sense to me. I'm a believer.
All right.
I'm with you 100%. Yeah.
Good. All right. Let's wrap things up with a lightning round. This has been great. I love to read a few of my favorite quotes, and then you respond telling us what it means to you. And Roger, give us the very first thing that comes to mind, because it's called a lightning round. This one's from Leonardo da Vinci. One can have no smaller or greater mastery than mastery of oneself.
That's true. I mean, it's so true. I mean, mastery of oneself. I mean, how do you start there? I mean, starting out as a baby and then till you're about to pass on, I guess, you know, if you felt like you've mastered yourself, then I guess that's happy.
That makes you happy. From Bruce Lee. Absorb what is useful, discard what is not, and add what is uniquely your own.
Brilliant. Yeah, that's brilliant. You know, and that's individualism, I guess, you know, being an original person, you know.
Yeah, and that's what you've been doing with your life, and that's what you do with your guitars, right? That's
right.
The process.
That's it.
That's the process for all of us, folks. That's Bruce Lee has it. Okay, from Joan Jett. My guitar is not a thing. It's an extension of myself. It's who I am.
Same here. Me and Joan, yeah, we're right there. I couldn't have said it better myself.
I picked that one just for you, my friend. Here's another one. I don't know the artist, the author, you may know. Remember, this is a quote, remember, the best instruments come from contented luthiers.
That's from a friend of mine. The name is Dick Shelley, better known as Vrabu. He wrote that, and we used it in advertising many years ago. Yeah, he meant it. He's a musician and a brilliant guy as well. And he's one of my best friends of all time.
Oh, right on. Okay, this is from Robert Greene. Mastery is not a function of genius or talent. It's a function of time and intense focus applied to a particular field of knowledge.
Yeah, that sounds like something Les Paul may have said.
From Robert Greene.
Yeah, well, that makes total sense. And practice.
Yeah.
Practice.
Yeah. Time. Okay, this is the last one. It's the show anchor from Goff. He says, whatever you can do or dream you can do, begin it. Boldness has genius, power, and magic in it. Begin it now.
I'm starting. These are brilliant quotes. Where do you come up with this stuff? You must do a lot of reading.
Begin awesome. It. All right. Well, that's great, Roger. So now, folks, it's your turn to play along with us. If you can hear my voice and you were inspired by today's show with Roger Fritz, please share some love with our brilliant broadcast team by giving what you can to WITV7. They're a 501c3 charity on a mission to educate, empower, and encourage. They do good works with your kindness. Roger, I love your relentless commitment to handcrafting world-class instruments that feature the very best qualities for electric and acoustic guitars for personal use, live performances, and studio perfection. And I admire your simple offer. And I quote, call me and we'll work together to produce an instrument I guarantee you'll cherish for life. And then you signed it, regards, Roger Fritz. And then you even give your phone number, 707-937-6060. My friend, that is so powerful. I love it. And I'm super happy that you shared your passion for mastery of your craft on our show today.
Well, thank
would you please just take a minute and share any parting remarks you'd like to leave with our audience?
Well, I want to say it was just a pleasure meeting you when you visited our lovely town. And it was real fun on New Year's.
Yeah.
And I hope you had as much fun as we did.
I did. It was great.
And, you know, we didn't have as many players here that night because, you know, there's, you know, the COVID thing and not everybody was getting out like we normally do. But, you know, it's awesome. And I appreciate your enthusiasm. I love it. And we just get a big charge out of it. And it's really a boost to us. You know, thank you so much for letting us be part of your thing.
Oh, thank you, my friend. So would you care to play us a song?
Sure, I'll be glad to. I'll just get my guitar and strap it on here and play a song.
Perfect.
I think I'm going to play the very first song I ever learned.
Okay.
And this goes way back. You may have heard it. It's called Honky Tonk.
Oh, yes.
You ever heard that one? Loud enough?
Yep. I thought you were starting to sing right there and you were asking a question.
That's no word.
That's wonderful, Roger. Thank you so much. Keep playing. I'm going to close the show out with a little background music. I've never had this before. So I also want to thank WITV7 for hosting and promoting our show so we can keep interviewing inspiring guests like Roger and reaching folks just like you, ready to create your own extraordinary lives. A special thank you to our sponsors for the entire month of March, Dry Farm Wines and Happy Living. Remember, I'll donate 8% of every purchase that you make for the entire month to WITV7. So tell all your friends too. Go to happyliving.com, select partners, and shop Dry Farm Wines. And most especially, thank you, viewers and listeners. You'll find links to websites and social media and all things Roger Fritz. Find him, friend him, visit his website, and buy a high quality, handmade, one-of-a-kind guitar like the one you're looking at right now. Go have a look at them at fritzbrothersguitars.com. That's all one word, F-R-I-T-Z, brothersguitars.com. From me to you, dear friends, I love you, and I want you to be really, truly, deeply happy. And speaking of happy, go to happyliving.com right now and take our happy quiz. Because when you measure your happy, you'll focus your attention on it. And focusing attention on it inspires change and learning and improvement to flow right into your life. And speaking of life improvement, I hope Roger has got you motivated and feeling confident and bold and excited to improve your life, ready to bring to life your unique and distinct reason for being on this planet. Because that's how you'll make your mark of significance on the world. And the world needs to hear from you. Till next time, I'm Matt Gersper. You are awesome. And this is a Something Significant show. And we're out. Right on, Roger.